and we're here today to unbox the Zenbook 14 with AMD's 5800H processor. So let's get started. First, we'll do the unboxing of the unit. We'll go over the physical characteristics of the notebook itself. Then we'll get into the guts of the unit. We'll talk about the data ports, explain the technical capabilities, and then we'll do some miscellaneous wrap-up with Windows 11 Professional, and then do a little bit of a summary. I've always been a fan of Asus. I think they have really well-designed products. This, I hope, is no exception. It comes with some paperwork, of course, in general. The actual notebook computer itself. Very nice ergonomic case. Kind of a unique power supply, and it's a box with your standard power cord cable. Has a USB Ethernet adapter, so if you need to plug directly into a network, got that. It also has a little carrying case to give your notebook a little bit of extra protection. There you go. That's basically the package contents that you get with the computer right there. Bought it from Newegg for $999 plus tax. Okay, so let's review the overall physical characteristics of it. It's a 14-inch screen. It's not touch. So my last one was touch. Downside of a touchscreen is you're going to get a lot of fingerprints on it, so you may or may not decide you want a touch screen. It's 2.87 pounds or approximately 1.3 kilograms. I really like the touch and the feel of the keyboards and this ergonomic. I mean, it's so easy to open. The last Asus that I bought was almost impossible to open the lid on it. So when they say an ergonomic lid that's easy to open, that is absolutely true. Looking at the ports, you have a full-size HDMI port right here. You have two USB-C ports, and we'll get into a little bit more detail on the technical details of the ports later. On this side, you have a combined microphone headphone jack there. You have a micro, can't hardly see it, but SD card slot here, and you have one USB 3.0 port right here. So onto the internal workings of this. It has a Ryzen 7 5800H processor. Has a 3.2 gigahertz sustained clock speed with a 4.4 gigahertz burst speed. It has 8 individual cores with 2 threads per core for a total of 16 threads. Has a half a megabyte of level 1 cache integrated into the CPU. Has a 4 megabyte level 2 cache and a 16 meg level 3 cache. The nice thing about the 16 meg level 3 cache is that it's now integrated in the Zen 3 architecture across all 8 cores that can simultaneously access that cache as needed. The unit has 16 gigabytes of LPDDR4X RAM. Okay, that's vice the DDR4 RAM. It's optimized for low power as opposed to the DDR4 RAM. However, since DDR4 RAM is not soldered onto the motherboard, if you have a unit that has the DDR4 RAM, it can usually be upgraded to a higher capacity SIM. With this, you're locked into the 16 gigabytes. You cannot change it. It has an AMD Radeon Vega 7 graphics card with shared system memory. It has a 1 terabyte PCIe NVMe solid state device. It's Wi-Fi 5 versus the latest Wi-Fi 6. It's 802.11ac with Bluetooth 5.0. Everything in the nomenclature for USB 3 and above, 3.0 and above, has been redesignated as 3.2. Okay, so what does this particular unit have? It has one USB previously 3.0, now a Gen 1, 3.2 Gen 1. So this is a 5 gigabit per second port. The two USB-Cs are 3.2 Gen 2, and they have the 10 gigabit maximum throughput speed. And they also power delivery, which means that most of your USB devices can be powered through here and recharged. Now, Windows 11 Pro, let's talk about that versus the home for this particular computer. One of the key features is BitLocker for encrypting your data on the device is available in Pro, but not on the home version. You also have additional enterprise management capabilities, which for an enterprise network would be of use. For a home user, probably not of that much interest. Pro also comes with the virtual machine Hyper-V manager, which allows you to run different operating systems on the Windows 11 machine. Again, probably more tailored towards development folks as opposed to home users. The one thing that you might, even as a home user, be interested in is that Pro has something called a sandbox. And the nice thing about that is you can actually install a program as though you were running it on Windows 11, see what it does, how it acts, behaves. And then when you close the sandbox, it's like you've thrown the sand away. There's no more footprint of the program. Another thing I want to get into is this idea of a ruggedized MIL standard 810G specification that a lot of the manufacturers are using. But that standard in and of itself telling you that it complies, all that means is they tested it to some level, but that's not the details of the level. For example, the ruggedness of this is if you dropped it 4 inches four times, that was the standard level of the test for the MIL standard 810G test that Asus did for the drop test. In summary, this was a review and unboxing of the Zenbook 14 with AMD Ryzen 7 5800H CPU. Model number was UM425QA. Primarily purchased for video editing. We'll do some subsequent reviews on it to see how it performs. Hope you found the video helpful. Consider subscribing. If you have any questions, please let us know. This is Rick with Cybermedics, signing out.